There comes the caravan across the bridge. Haribo!
Mes respects, hein, j'ai quand même croisé une personnalité. Bonjour à tous, et c'est bien la Loire.
Le rythme, le même rythme, mais pas pour faire une accélération. Donc malheureusement, je suis resté un peu en retard.
Vous l'aviez coché celle-là, il y en a d'autres que vous avez coché?
Oui, il y avait hier et aujourd'hui. Donc c'est pour ça que je m'étais relevé il y a quelques jours. C'était pour essayer d'avoir un maximum d'écart pour pouvoir jouer une des deux échappées. Hier, ça ne l'a pas fait et aujourd'hui, ça, ça a été donc bon, c'était déjà la satisfaction de pouvoir faire la course devant et puis de jouer d'être acteur. Après maintenant le résultat il n'est pas spécialement ce que j'avais espéré.
D'accord.
Yeah.
35 years old, two Vuelta España stage wins. Did you think that Tour de France win was getting close today? You finally were going to get it?
Yeah, well, I've learned so far that until you don't cross the line, there's no point really thinking about it. But it was in the back of my mind when I was in the group and I saw the climbers over there. I was like, all right, I think on the last climb I could probably go with Benoot, and I did. I wasn't planning on Daryl to make it back across in the last kilometer. He must have climbed really well the last few Ks. And then on the descent, I think my plan was to give everything on that climb and see how it was going afterwards, because I knew that if the bigger horsepower were with me by the top, I would have lost anyway. The problem was then when we came through that town with a little kicker, when Benoot attacked from behind, I just didn't have the explosivity to follow him.
Daryl indeed, he's the powerhouse, he was the danger man.
Yeah, totally. With Benoot, I think it would have been a 50-50, even though we know how fast he can be as well, but on a two-man sprint, you never know. But once Daryl came in there, it was already a different scenario. But like I said, I was lacking a little bit of explosivity when they went on that little kicker.
Nicholas, you've done everything. What do you take out of this escape today? Is there anything you can take out of it? Positive
is it was a long time I didn't get goosebumps on a stage, and today I had goosebumps going up the climb, and especially one of the earlier ones, and the one after 35K. There was so much crowd there. I was just like, this is what, when you're a kid, you dream about going up the climbs with all these crowds, and I was kind of living the dream for a moment again. And it was nice to be back in a Tour de France breakaway. Thanks.
Pretty thought that might be a stage filler, Michael Matthews, but was it the plan to go into the group because yesterday was such a tough stage?
Well, I don't think everybody did, or at least the 15 guys that were with me didn't think about it. In my opinion, today and yesterday were stages that were,
good job, man.
Thank you, that were really open, and hence the complicated tactics, because after yesterday, I think it could have been one or the other, or the brake was going bananas yesterday and teams don't control and they control today. But to be able to control the same way as the peloton did yesterday takes a lot of energy out of everybody, and we're only 10 days in the race, so I think everybody, or 9 days in the race, but I think everybody was looking forward for a breakaway.
Yeah, so is that something that you have in your mind when you start going into a group like today?
Yeah, I mean, today we did start with the idea that it was a good stage for Michael, but we also kept it in the back of our mind that everything will be kind of decided regarding on the breakaway. If the breakaway went straight away with 3, 4, 5 riders, I probably think we would have committed for Michael. But there was also the possibility that 15 guys went up the road, and this is where my role was, where I had to do my role, which was go with those groups.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
Man, huh?
Bravo, yeah?
Sorry, this is me. Oh, what a legend.
Fuck, that feels good, eh?
Just gives his heart and soul to this team, and always supporting other riders for victory. And he got his due, like he's probably his 7th Tour de France. He's had his ups and downs, and he got what he deserved. He fucking works hard, and
couldn't be more happier.
And when you watch the replay, that comes through on the bike, man. He grit his teeth. He was gone a couple of times. He fought back. He attacked.
I've got to watch the highlights, man. I've had no information other than what he won, so I haven't seen it yet.
But he gives everything, like you say.
Yeah, exactly.
How deserving is he of this? I mean, some of the riders, not even on your team, are saying, anyone deserves it with him?
For sure. He's a selfless rider. Just be happy for him. As a friend of mine as well, personally, and, you know, just, yeah, it's really nice.
Quite champagne?
Yeah.
Well, we'll have a drink on the way back to the hotel. Que jamais le régional de l'étape. Romain, vous avez fait plaisir à tous vos supporters qui sont ici devant vous. Vous avez tenté quelque chose. Est-ce que c'est signe que ça va mieux?
Donner tout ce qu'on a au fond de nous et surtout avec l'étape.
Vous le voyez, Romain Bardet, avec l'amour des siens, regonflé à bloc qui nous promet certainement des belles choses pour la suite de ce Tour de France.
Finis.